The complex tangent is the quotient of complex sine and cosine, just as in the real case. This means that properties like derivative and maximal domain resemble the real case. Computing images of points is standard, computing inverse images is tricky, though, as you will see in this video. So, what's our tangent function? F from domain is to see f of z equals tangent z equals sine of z over cosine of z. So, what's the domain? What's the maximal domain? Well, we can compute this unless cosine z equals 0, and we have seen that it is the case for z equals pi over 2 plus a multiple of pi. As maximal domain, we can choose all z in C unless you're dividing by 0. So, in that case, f of z equals sine of z over cosine of z. Sine is analytic, cosine is analytic. So, quotient of analytic functions is analytic, unless you're dividing by 0, which we're not doing now. So, the tangent of z is analytic. And its derivative can be computed using the quotient rule, just as in the real case, and equals 1 over cosine squared of z. Well, if you want to find the image of some complex number, you can just plug it in. You have sine over cosine, you compute the sine and the cosine of the number, and then you're done. So that's not so difficult. Finding inverse images, though, is a bit more tricky. So that's an example we'll do. So find all z in C such that the tangent of z equals some complex number. Minus 2 minus I. So we want to find all z satisfying the equation tangent z equals minus 2 minus I. And let's call this right inside W for a moment. We know what W is, but just to make the notation a bit easier, we'll call minus 2 minus I W. And then later on, we will plug in what W is. I want to solve for z. So, what do we do? Well, first we use the definition. Tangent of z equals sine of z over cosine of z. You see the 1 over 2i divided by 1 half yields 1 over I. And then we can use it, we have only e to the power I z. So we say, well, let's define a p equals e to the power I z. So, like that. Then the e to the power minus I z becomes a 1 over p. So we get the p minus 1 over p divided by p plus 1 over p. Multiply by p, you get p squared minus 1 over p squared plus 1 equals still w. And now you see you can solve for p. We will first find p, and then we plug in back p equals e to the power iz, and then we will find z. So, multiply this equals w left and right by I to get rid of this factor 1 over I. You get p squared minus 1 over p squared plus 1 equals I times w. Now, to solve for p, so bring this p squared plus 1 to the other side, we find p squared minus 1 equals I times w times p squared plus 1. Bring all p squared to the left and all the constants to the right. So the minus 1 goes to the right and the iw times p squared goes to the left. So we get the p squared times 1 minus iw equals 1 plus iw. And then you can solve for p squared. So you know what p is. So we know p squared equals e to the power 2 times I times z. And now we plug in our number w. W equals minus 2 minus I. And in this case it's 1 plus iw. Divided by 1 minus iw becomes simplifies a bit. That's due to the choice of this number over here, which we chose nicely in this example. Because in the denominator we get 1 plus 2i plus I squared, so that's minus 1, so we are only left with 2i. And in the numerator we get 1 minus 2i minus I squared, so that yields 2 minus 2i, which simplifies minus 2i over 2i equals minus 1. And 2 over 2i yields 1 over I equals minus I. So now we have to solve p squared, e to the power 2iz or p squared equals minus 1 minus I. Right, the right hand side is a complex exponential. Its argument equals minus 3 pi over 4 and its norm square root of 2. So there you are. And write it into one exponent. So the square root of 2 equals e to the power ln square root of 2 equals e to the power 1 half ln times ln of 2. And then we have e to the power z1 equals e to the power z2. So we know that z1 equals z2 plus a multiple of 2 pi I. So 2iz equals what's in the exponent here plus a multiple of 2 pi I, where k is in z. And then we can solve for z by dividing by 2i. The minus 3 pi over 4 yields 3 pi over 8. The k times 2 pi I yields k times pi. And 1 half ln of 2 divided by 2i equals 1 over 4 I ln of 2. So minus I over 4 times the ln of 2, where k is can be any number in z. So you see, if you solve tangent that equals something, you get some number plus a multiple of pi. But this last fact won't surprise you, because that's very similar to the real case. If you solve tangent that equals something, you get an angle plus a multiple of pi. So that resembles the real case.